really nervous. We brought you out first before we meet your lovely daughter. Do not shake. We're fine.
I'm shaking.
No, do not shake.
Well, where is her little girl?
Tell me all about Lucy.
Wow, where would you like me to start?
From birth, if you want.
From there. Oh, well, when she was born, we didn't know whether she was told that there was something wrong.
Lisa was diagnosed with cancerous tumours of the eyes. We were in a cancer bubble for a long time, which was horrendous, I'm not going to lie. It was really bad. And we were in and out of hospital, and I had to watch them pin my daughter down because she didn't want this. And she cried, and she kicked, and she screamed. I've never seen Lucy cry as much as she did. You look at these nurses and doctors, and they're saying to you, you know, we know what we're doing, and you have to trust them. You have to trust them. And that's the hard part, because you're the mum. She sang to the fish in the ocean. As she stands now, she hasn't got any vision at all. On top of that, Lucy has a chromosome 16 duplication. I have it. I have it. It can affect mental health. It can affect autism traits. She's globally developmentally delayed as well. So she struggles with communication. She can't hold a conversation, not really. And the seashells clapped. Good girl. And the seagulls flapped.
Amazing.
However, long time ago, when she was very little, she had a little tiny keyboard. And we took it into hospital with us. And she played Twinkle Twinkle Little Star perfectly on it. And the nurse came over. And she thought that it was pre-recorded. And I said, no, Lucy's playing it. And the nurse just went, that's spectacular. And that's when Daniel came in and started working with her.
I'm Daniel Bass, and I do a lot of teaching through Amber Trust, which is a charity that helps blind musicians. Our lessons aren't like normal piano lessons. Because she can't see what's happening, I started using a method of where I would play the piano and she would put her hands on top of my hands so she could feel which fingers were doing what. I've never met anybody in my career who has the same depth of understanding of music.
Hi Lucy, it's Claudia. Hi darling, lovely to meet you. Thank you for coming.
Music is the way that she communicates, and that's how she makes her place in the world.
Now, come on, that's a big step coming up to the piano. Ready, big step? Good girl. Well done. Come and sit down in the middle.
Down.
Just find the pedal.
We should say that often at the end of a performance,
yes,
Lucy covers her ears.
She likes the applause, but she doesn't like the sound of the applause.
Yes.
So her fingers go in her ears for sensory reasons.
Yes, I don't have to tell people not to.
She loves applause.
Okay, fine.
100%.
Now, ready? In a minute you're going to play Nocturne in B flat minor by Chopin. Just start playing. See? Here we go.
Incredible.
Oh my God, this is impossible.
Lucy, it was so lovely to meet you. You were tremendous.
Yay! Hey. You're a clown.
Everyone now.
Yeah.
More than none.
More than I deserve.
I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. I really don't know what to say.
For two pernickety, opinionated, pains in the asses to be completely flummoxed and speechless.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, technically speaking, she sang those melodies.
Yeah.
You sing when you play. It's like
put a voice here, and I always tell the people I work with. I say, don't play just the. Because when you're seeing it, you have to think about, right? Yeah.
Basically turning a percussion instrument,
yeah.
A tuned percussion instrument, into
a breathing voice.
A breathing, living,
yeah.
vocal instrument. And it took a 13-year-old girl to show us how to do that.
Yes, she can. She can. She really sings so well.
And she did it.
There.
I feel very, very lucky. If you told me that I was going to live one of my strongest musical experiences of the past 5-10 years sitting in a train station in Leeds, I would have been like completely out of your mind.